Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What are we doing back in here? Well, I forgot to collect this thing from the cupboard. And before I forget, check out the playlist if you haven't already. The playlist info, the description. Underneath the standard, like, stats thing that I put for, you know, the what year the game came out, what genre, etc. I have actually taken the liberty of looking at a scan of the, or picture of the box art. The original box art, which is only in Germany, because remember, this game was only officially released in German. And with a German to English Google Translate, I have translated all the text on there. Of course, you know, translated in quotes, because it's a very rudimentary translation. Of course, it's Google Translate. So, and edited a line or two I took out because it just didn't make any sense, or I changed something around to have it make more sense, so it's not literally word by word. You know, sometimes, especially with Google Translate, it won't make sense. So it's more of a very amateur localization, I guess, of the the text on the back of the Ambermoon box, which is, there's quite a lot of text there. Very interesting. So, I was glad I did that. It took me a long time, though. There's a lot of big words. It's interesting, too, because you can see when you you're typing in the German text. It probably exists on the internet somewhere, but I couldn't find it. So I just typed it in, and you can see how the English translation on the other side is much shorter. Because some German words are hella long. Anyway, we have to get this thing. And I mean, I'm not sure what to do with this, but it's not heavy, right? I just don't think so. No, not really. So I got it. So close to my weight, but maybe I can sell this somewhere? Because it doesn't look like anything I can interact with. Unless it's maybe a quest item or something. Which I kind of doubt. And in here, there's something else I wanted to address as well. Oh, I left my rocks. I think I'm just going to leave them, though, because I can't take them. They're too heavy. At least for now. We need, unfortunately, going to waste a torch just to see this thing, but that's okay. Right, so the seller, now this setting, options, now this stuff is not grayed out. Kind of silly though. Why wouldn't they make it available throughout the whole game to see, you know? But you have floor textures, ceiling textures. And ta-da, it looks like that. What do you guys think? Kind of weird. It's very busy. It's like, I don't know, like zoomed in or something. I'm gonna try to get used to moving around maybe like this. Oh wow. See, if I go like that, but I tend to turn with the mouse. Maybe I'll just turn with the mouse. I wasn't turning. I was strafing, I think. Okay, so yeah. It kind of moves at a respectable pace, and it gets stuck now and then. Maybe I'll mess with the 3D accelerator functions? I don't know. But anyway, we got it on now. And then, I enabled the ceiling things. I just want to try, I don't know. Those two other chests were definitely trapped. And I want to be able to undo them, but I have... Find trap and disarm trap. I have zero. So there's no chance of me being able to undo a trap, right? Now I think... To pick a lock... I think a lock pick gives you plus 5%. I think it's 5%? I'm not even sure. I kind of want to pick one of them, right? So let's just... What are we on now? 6? This is the one I couldn't get into, right? But I don't know if I tried with the lockpicks. It's that. It's the thing. Wait, is it not this? Or it is this. Right. So does I don't discover any traps. I don't have any chance to discover any traps. Unable to pick the lock. Yeah, okay. I gotta come back here with something. Maybe if I get Grandpa's armor, he'll give me a key to some of these things. In which case, bypassing traps and such. Anyway, I'm done. I will now load. And get out of here. Out into the great world beyond. That's a tree, right? I kind of think it was like a spinal cord of some huge spinal column of some huge creature. But no, I think it's just a tree. Are these special mushrooms we can pick or something? That'd be cool. Nope. How about these special ones? Special looking ones, anyway. Notice it's gray. See how it's gray like that? You think once it, if you like mouse over, or not, yeah, I guess you're mousing over something, it turns color, right? That'd be a cool feature. But I'm not sure if it does, so. Trying to pick mushrooms now. I got some little pond here. Try to mess around by Grandpa's window. Alright. Nothing happens. More road. Kinda think, you know, these remind me of the herbs from Amberstar. I forget what the yellow ones do. Are they just called like yellow flower and red flower or something? Okay, this just fades off the we lost the road. And I think we might want to stick to the road for the time being, so. We got water here that will probably damage us if we cross it. That's a bridge, okay. It kind of looks like a partition. Like, it's trying to look 3D here, but this is the 2D world. It kind of looks like this is... This is back, right? And then these two partitions go forward diagonally. But no, that's a ramp and a bridge. Oh, we're losing light. I remember that. North, Hoiman Desert, South Spannenberg. And we don't have access to the map. Alright. South. What's that? south across the bridge, I guess, then. It just kind of ends here, yeah. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Across the bridge we go. I want my clock. I miss my clock. What's that? You're getting closer than that. Is that the same thing we couldn't interact with before? Cool. You'll be able to return to this point later. Fast travel? Really? Oh, you know, the back of the box actually mentions something about that. They didn't call it fast travel. Get back here. Oh, he's right in my face. Hi. The old man looks at you in astonishment and says, "It is really strange that people come to Spannenberg, although the town is full of bandits." Oh, lovely. No, he doesn't say anything else. All right. And he's backing off. Maybe I'm a bandit. You ever think about that? Okay. City gates. That's a go-to point. Okay. So... I thought something was happening there. So I can just click that and go right to the city gates at any point, I'm guessing. Except for during combat. Alright, what's this say? Can I go forward more? Inn of the Limping Rogue. Oh, I love the music so much. They have these weird things around. So how do we get in the inn? Looks like here. I'll be able to turn there later as well. Oh, that's where I came out from. Wait, and that's the city gates. Is that the same old man? Probably. Okay, that is... So what about this? A sign on the door to the south says reception, and below that, rooms to let. That's reception. Welcome, what brings you to my fine inn? Not sleeping, because I don't have enough money for it, I'm sure. 15 gold pieces, grade new. I'm saving in case these things are trapped. Y hits yes. Okay, good. Can I hit E for exit? No. Although I can probably hit 9 on the keypad, yeah. So if you quickly want to save, just... It would be 1, I guess 4, no, I have to select it, 4, enter, Y, and then 9. I might get used to that. I can't even do anything with these anyway. I gotta try, you know? Is this trap too? Yeah. Although it's not actually a trap, it's just a fireplace. No other rooms in or out of this place? Okay. Oh, there's somebody here now. Hi. Oh, I can actually look! You see a man of middle age. He has a short, dark beard and looks at you questioningly. Hey, why the hell are you in my room, basically? What if I click this on him? Something. Like, push him around or something. Oh. He's on me! A man. Oh, he is a man. He's a fifth level thief, age 36. Hello, stranger. You are visiting Spannenberg at such a bad time. At the moment, we have big problems in the Guild of Thieves. I could possibly invite him to my group. Hello. You don't know anything special about hello. Thieves Guild. I hope I can trust you and that you are not one of those strange bandits who have been running around here for some time. The guild and the trainers are in the cellar below this bar, but you need a password to get past the Stonehead. If you bring me a certain thing, I will tell you the word. Of course you will. Certain thing. Our gardener at the graveyard has a brooch, which means a lot to me, but unfortunately I cannot get at it, and certainly not since he is constantly surrounded by skeletons and zombies. If you bring me the brooch, I will give you the password. Surrounded by skeletons and zombies. I don't know if I'm ready. I'm only level 2, guy. I don't know if I'm ready to be taking on skeletons and zombies. Bandits. Yes, for the last few weeks, some strange bandits have been plundering the town. And more than that, their actions are casting the Guild of Thieves into a bad light. We simply cannot make it clear to the citizens of Spannenberg that we have nothing to do with the bandits. We used to have a really good relationship with them. Everyone has their job, and it did not bother the people that we had ours. Your job is to steal from other people, though. That should bother people. I don't know if these are just words that apply to him, or these are new words. But, yeah. At this point, at least both. May Bela protect you and ensure that you are not overpowered by bandits. Thanks. Alright. What's the guy's name? A man. He is a man. He's a man named A Man. A man... Get brooch from graveyard in parentheses skulls zombies for thieves guild password. All right, got you in my book, buddy. So I think we came in here. We came from there. Do I look around in here? This is the same guy, isn't he? I'm pretty sure it's him. I'm just checking. I like how they have little, you know, send-offs now. I thought that would just be the grandfather for some reason. They have little goodbye things. I'm trying to talk to that. Duh. Let's look in here. Any books? Well, there is more to this place. Some old guy with a robe? An old lady? An old man with a crutch says, "I hope someone does something very soon about that band of orcs from the mountains to the west. They are making life difficult for the farmers." Orcs? Mountains to west. I guess this is not a quest, right? I'm gonna put "not quest" in parentheses because this has appeared. I'm gonna return to him for any reason. Here's another. A lot of old people around here. Run into like a senior citizens community. An old man with a long gray beard welcomes you. "Hello, my name is Landis." After exchanging a few pleasantries, how's the weather? He says, "I would advise you to avoid the graveyard behind the house of the healers, for I have heard that Gordon, the graveyard gardener, has started to recall the dead to an unnatural life. I personally never trusted him anyway, and certainly not any more since he bought every possible book on necromancy." Alright, so this is more on that. The guy's name is Gordon. Good brooch. Gordon. Necromancer? Question mark. Anything else to say? Is this why you guys can't defend against the orcs? Because you're all, like, really old except for that one guy? Oh, that must be the Thieves Guild area. Oh, well, that must be the Thieves Guild area. Did you say it was downstairs? I'm not sure. Well, there might be a dungeon down there if otherwise. What about this kitchen? Can I get in there? Well, maybe that leads to the kitchen. Maybe even though it looks like it's up a flight of stairs, it's all visible on this same map here. Yeah, it is. Okay. Thought so. Roasting on a spit, it is. I want to turn the spit around and cook stuff. There's all this stuff, but it's not interactable. Doesn't it look like you can climb through there? What is that? Unknown. What's in the pot? Oh, I literally can't go that way. Okay. Watch me hurt myself by touching fire. Well, I'm trying to interact with things. It just won't let me. What's this stuff? Anything? So I say it was one. Because I'm going to be saving in a lot. Be able to return to this point later. The Rogue's Wine Cellar. Sounds pretty dangerous. I don't know if the rogues down here would like me very much. As you reach the foot of the cellar steps, the smell of alcohol wafts into your face. You see footprints leading to the west in the half-dried puddles of beer and wine. To the west. Well, which way are we facing? I guess, yeah, we're facing west. Oh, we found to fight some spiders? Well, you didn't have to. So yeah, these are actual polygons, including on the ceiling. Well, that's run. Oh, if you do that, you run. Okay, that's cool. Secret area? No. Secret wall? There's a door here. So another door. What is that? Something's up there. Oh, it's a keg. Cask or whatever. Alright, I saw that hallway. I don't think those for some more. Oh, we can fight some spiders. So far, yeah, we haven't gotten those casts to be interactable. So there's plenty we haven't explored. We just went through that door. I'm gonna fight spider. Yes, I'd like to fight. Oh my god, there's four of them? Yeah, some of these hits might come through. Luckily these aren't poisonous that we've seen. It did a point. Ah, failed. It's on my... I did five. This thing is on the same thing as mine. I thought they couldn't advance to my, you know, little row of squares here. Maybe instead it's around me. Maybe you can't come closer because it should have run right up to me instead of stopped there. And keep repeating until one's dead. Return. Oh, it's next to me. It's just gonna move to... They're all gonna go first. That's what I hate. Okay, I've moved. So I can only hit this one right now. So these two will probably advance, I guess, up to me. And then what will that one do? Go next to him? Or will it go up to here, next to me again? We'll find out. It moved in front of the other. Okay, so this is the one that's actually damaged, and now this one's damaged. I don't know how that one moved next to me. This must work differently. I mean, I thought even as far as Albion, they couldn't move on the same row as you. Another point of damage on me. I mean, they could wear me down by attrition with their numbers. I need to keep a track on this one, because this one's damaged. Unless they regenerate. So whenever I can reach that one, I want to go for it. How am I doing? I'm down 3 points. I'm down 5 points. Luckily, I leveled up, so I have a bigger pool of points now. Another 2 damage. And 1. My attack failed. I'm like halfway. Oh, I keep forgetting. I only have to go like that. So this is where I would normally be at the start of the fight for level 1. I want to get rid of 1. I really do. Nice. You're gone, buddy. Now this one's unhurt, unfortunately. Now that one moves next. I did 4 points. Poof! Nice! Maybe that was the one I hurt before. We'll see, because I thought it was this one. Now I only got 2 going after me. 5. No, I guess they fooled me, yeah. That one's undamaged, I think. Okay. So how many points that one has? It has more than 8. Big spider retreats. A! I hate that. If I had ranged, I could still shoot an arrow or a sling stone over. I'm trying to take it out because they're 20 experience each, I believe. And I want that 20 XP. Now I'm fighting a fresh one that's undamaged. Coward. You could have defeated me. Tell you could have done it. 6 points. Damn you! Ah, oh, I can't advance further. Ah! 80? Oh. Well, either I got experience for them anyway, or they're 40 each. I don't think they're 40 each. I'm pretty sure they were 20. So even though the thing flees, I got experience points. Maybe if you do a certain amount of damage on it, you get the XP anyway. That's very fair. That's very fair, if so. Another keg of something. What? Healing potion 1. These restore 2 each. They're not really useful. Or 1 each? And I have 10? Maybe it was using two before it gives you two. But I know that... No, I thought this gave you 2 points and this gave you five. Maybe it's a percentage of points. In which case this is becoming useless because for level two it will only... If that's true, I gotta look back at my old videos. If that's true, this here gave me 2 points at level one. And then at level two, it gave me 1 point. So, either, if that's true, it's either gonna be level three, it's gonna give me a fraction of a point, or it's gonna stay one. I mean, I'll just use it, because they're basically useless in combat. At least I'm almost full now. Do a jaunty jig! It's just another keg. The Rogue's Wine Cellar. Alright, exploring. So where are all the rogues at?